Hello, Ranos here, and welcome episode of Space Engineers. In this episode, take a look at the panels plus by Stone, small Helm by Clinio, as well as another update to the medieval structures by Maxime. So, how about we get started with the medieval structures update? So, first up. So here, a couple of new pieces have been added. Not many, but a few. Like, first of all, there's the corner piece for the roof. Thus, you can have the, what's this again? I forget. Yeah, bunk. The wooden clay wall. Let's see. You can have that going all the way to the top. And this part of your roof. In fact, build your home entirely out of it. And there's also now a doorway made of wooden clay for your homes. And even as part of an interior. So you can actually divide your home into different rooms. And instead of using the stone corners, you can now use wooden ones. Look pretty nice. I wonder if that can change colour. Probably not, but I am curious. This may lag the video. And then change. And then change. Oh well, never mind. Whoop a shot. Not only that, you see, we got some drawers. This is a storage container, allowing to store 125 litres of cargo, of items. So, say if I wanted to, I can stuff a few of those in there. I get much shots, wait, much more than that, but still. There's some in there. It was better to get rid of all that stuff. Yeah. It's just basic medieval additions. So your house can even look even more medieval. Make it look more like a peasant home rather than a castle. Or have a castle that has a little bit of wooden clay structure on top. What do you buy? Or something. We can also have interesting structures of these. But the one thing I would like to see is not that one. Why on earth is that like that anyway? We'll get to it. Yeah, like this piece. Like versions of this particular piece that actually has the furniture on it. Such as the drawers, the chair, the table, brazier. Wrong one. Yeah, just so that you can have these sorts of things on the inside. Yeah, like have this on top so you can light up the inside of your home. Like even have a version for this, so you can have this on your upper floor rather than your bottom floor. Then again, I guess it really matters because sometimes I even have this outside because it's for crafting. And not that one. Yeah, like I've even these seats just sitting on top of it and the table. And I would say that'd be pretty good. Also, one thing I'd like to see when I find the bugger. I think I went right past the darn thing that I did. Hey, where are you? There you are. Like a standalone version of this torch. That way you can stick it on the other side if you wanted to. That's one hell of a big flame. Huh. It's a shame that if you try setting this, it will turn off. So yeah, I like have a standalone version of that one. The version of these with all the different furniture on it. It would be pretty handy. So anyway, why don't we move on to the next one? Which is going to be Panels Plus. Which is a set of blocks for the small ship. And as the name suggests, it's just a bunch of panels. But all of them are angled. In a way that could be quite useful. In fact, they would have been useful in a few of my other builds. Granted, a large ship, but still. You got these ones that will fit along with these two. You got these two that fits along with these two. And that's how we just pair them all up. As for these, you see they start at the front of the block, and they finish in the middle. Which then these ones will continue from the middle. The edge. exactly sure exactly how it goes on. See, that's that one over there. Yeah, that's this one here, as you can see. And I think this one is actually more for... No, it fits on there quite nicely. Oh, wait. Oh, you don't fit. I thought they would have fit. They fit with their counterparts. They fit with these ones though. Unless you want them going back on themselves. Which could actually be the sort of design you're after. Then if you keep on going, get some other variants like those ones. Don't think this is it yet. No. Yeah. See, those ones fit in line with that one much better. But not with these, unless you do it like that. Maybe an odd design choice, to be honest. That one fits there as well. So you can bunch of pieces to do a variety of different designs. You see with these ones, they go from one of the block all the way to the other, diagonally. And that's the other side, and there you've got their counterparts that continue with the diagonal motion. Although it's a bit tricky to get them onto that one, but I guess it's more for acting as their wing tip or something like that. I won't go well with that one because they don't. I would have the problem with that one, wouldn't it? I doubt the other way up, it would fit. So why don't we get it the other way up? And bonk. And we go grab that piece. Bonk like that. So yeah. Fits on just like that. I'm pretty sure I was actually aiming for the other way around. So we'll get to the next piece. Wrong rotation. Oh, it's not gonna work. Yeah, got to be like that. And you have these other diagonal pieces. Instead of being the two-block ramp, it's just the single-block ramp. As you can see, the different varieties of it being at different angles. You see, this one goes at the middle, that middle, that's also middle. They're basically the same, but the textures are at a different angle than the others. That way, it will help you decide... Wait a minute. That's flat on the bottom there. That's flat on the side. Oh. Now I see. That's what it was meant to be. Huh. There really is more angles too. And by the looks of it, we'll get back to whatever the hell's got me stuck here. This might actually have been the same situation. Where that was actually meant to be flat. Huh. That makes a lot of sense. Then we got these ones that go from one corner of the block all the way to the other corner. It's like those ones over there. And as for the build cost of these panels, you probably saw as I was scrolling through them, they're all just a single steel plate, so they are pretty cheap. So these can really spice up your aircraft. Or your land vehicles. Ooh, that's a thing. Made some pretty good spoilers of these. Ugh, I left my car at the medieval house. Huh, can't spot a spoiler on that. Would be interesting to do. Like mix it with this piece somehow. I guess there's actually quite a few ways I could mix it. Like not that one. Get this one. Put it on its side like that. Get its counterpart on its side. Like that. Switch back to the vanilla set. I No, there are thin ones for that. Wait, there we go. There was. Boom! There's a spoiler! Nice. So that's actually another way you can use this mod. Adding spoilers to your cars. And pseudo wings to your aircraft. Cool. So, how about we move on to the next one. The small helm. Which is a cockpit. Which only takes up a single block. So if you don't want it to look odd, I would recommend placing it on a pillar. It does need a space of 1.5 blocks in order to look proper. Otherwise you're either going through blocks or you're just floating. Which this is actually pretty good for sticking on the back of a sort of contraption. You know, like a contraption like that. Like this on the back so you control the mechanical arm or the turret or whatever else it may be. And a bonk. As you can see, standing on the slab pretty well. This will allow you to control whatever contraption it is attached to. Yeah, it's just a normal cockpit. Easy see. I wasn't really pressing G there. Yeah, just a simple cockpit. But its build cost, I think, isn't all that expensive. Let's see. 2 interior plates, 5 construction components, 1 motor, 5 computers, and 1 display. Yeah, you can modify display to be whatever you need it to be. Thus, when you're in first person, you actually have something to monitor. Why is the camera over my head? Strange. Oh well. Yeah, you can add this to any sort of contraption to add some more finite control rather than using buttons. Without needing to make a lot of space. Let's say, for instance, if we go to the other cockpits, and I paint the bloody things. And that one, that takes a bit of space, 3x3x3. This one is 2x3x3. That one's the same. This one's also 3x3x3. That's 2x3x3. That's not even a cockpit. That's not a cockpit. That's the bench. No, back of that one. Where the fuck was the helm? There's the vanilla helm. Where the fuck was it? Is it this bunch? Yeah, that's a really big one. That's big. Yeah, this thing. You see, it's actually a much smaller version. That needs a lot less space, because that's 3x4x3. You know, make it a lot easier to place this contraption on. Thus, well, you know, make things more compact. Oh yeah, this only has a mount point on the bottom. Yeah, that'd be, you don't even have to have on a tower like that. You could simply put it sticking out on a platform that's like this. So then you need that tower bit right underneath it. That could just be the thing that stuck out right in the bottom of the ship too. Oh, that contraption. Makes it quite useful. Not sure what that button's for. I guess none of these buttons and switches really do anything. So yeah, you can also tell you can recolor it and retexture it if you want to. Or to match the colors of your contraption. Oh, is that like a slab tour? Oh, a slab tour, should I say. That it is! Thus it can mesh in pretty well too. Handy. You know, this like stuck on the outside of a satellite. Just use this to maneuver it if you need to. Huh. That's an idea you could do for it. Well, instead of using a remote control block and having to be in a ship that has radio capabilities, just go up to the satellite, hop on this little thing, and maneuver it. That's what we need to do it. Yeah. There are all sorts of handy little things you can use this thing for. Well, and the other things you can do with it. You know what I mean. But now I'm curious, does it have a mount point on the back there? I did that. Three of those. Bring that to there. Put that on there. And delete you. Holy frick! Look at it! It's floating! Kind of. So yeah, even more options to do with it. Wow. That's a sad little thing, isn't it? Hmm. So yeah, that'll be that. I'll have a link for all three mods down in the description below. So you may play around with your own medieval house, make it even more medieval as time goes on. Or get some little panels that you can use to add spoilers and wings to your vehicles. As well as a teeny little cockpit that will help you control a variety of small contraptions that don't have room or vanilla cockpits. Very handy one, I must say. Probably the most useful one here. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.